Hello to everyone, guys. Sriman is back again after a long interval on this channel, and so actually I was very sorry. I have not uploaded videos before 2 or 3 going days. So actually I was just busy in my some of personal works, and so I have not any free time for making videos. So now I am very very sorry for this. Just I have promised to upload videos regularly, but actually I have just not any free time. I was so busy that just actually I can't make videos. So sorry for that. Sorry for this inconvenience. Now from today we will just continue our series. Now we will talk about matrices, determinants, and everything that we have just started before some days. And so now I am back again here, and from today we will just look afterwards. Okay, so if you are new on this channel, then I will just give you the introduction of this channel. This channel is totally dedicated to the students who are wishing to learn data science, machine learning, deep learning, mathematics, everything. So just we are just making videos on linear algebra, and then we will look upon calculus and some other things. And so actually we have to just make videos and explain the gist ups for data science perspective and a student of gate computer science. So actually these topics are very important for both. If someone is studying for preparing for gate computer science exam, or if anybody is a student of data science, is just learning machine learning and deep learning, so just these topics are very very important. And so we will discuss each and every topics of linear algebra, calculus, statistics, and some other topics. Till we have just talked about matrices, some of its types, like as null matrix, a scalar matrix, rectangular matrix, a square matrix, and symmetric matrix, skew symmetric matrices. We have just also discussed about transpose and their properties. So just we have discussed a lots of things, and we have also come to know about that what is a determinant and what are some properties. Let's see some other properties of determinants. So when we talk about the properties of determinants, so actually there are some properties, and let's read one by one. This one says that let A is equals to Aij, that is a that is a square matrix. So B a square matrix of order n, then the sum of the products of elements of any rows or columns with their cofactor is always equal to the determinant of A. So actually that is mathematically we can just write this statement, this whole statement into this line. Okay, so just wait for a minute. Actually my mouse pad is not working smoothly, so just wait, I will put something. Yes, now so just actually this property says that we have to just find the sum of the products of elements of any rows or columns with their cofactor. In previous video we have just discussed about what are cofactors. So cofactors are just they are the form of minors of the elements of matrices. So if you don't know about how to find cofactors and what are the cofactors, then you should just watch that video, watch the previous video once again, and then you should go to some prior knowledge about cofactors. But now here I will not describe that what is a cofactor and how to find it, because I have just discussed it in previous section. So just see here, if we have to multiply the element of a square matrix and its corresponding cofactor, that is A11 is the element and C11 is its cofactor. A12 is the element and C12 is the cofactor. Actually, this cofactor is corresponding to this element, okay? And so A13 multiplied with cofactor C13. So when we have to just we have to just do the sum of these elements. Actually, what this property says? This says that the sum of the products of elements of any rows or columns with their cofactor. So these are the corresponding cofactors, and so we have to just find its sum, and this sum will be equals to the determinant of A matrix, the square matrix A. So this is just a property, okay? Now this is also A11 dot C1 plus A21 dot C21 A31. Just actually this says that we have to just find the sum of products of elements of any rows or columns. So any rows or columns, that doesn't matter. So this this sum will just equal to this determinant of the square matrix, okay? Now coming on the next point, so there is some other point, and this will say that sum of the products of elements of any rows or columns with the cofactors of corresponding elements of any other rows or columns is equal to 0. Suppose that there is elements, and we have to just multiply these elements with the cofactors of some other elements or elements of some other rows or some other columns. Not actually actually in this property the elements and cofactors are just similar, because elements are in the first row and first column, that is Aij means A11, that means first row and first column, and so C11 means cofactor of the element of first row first column. So actually in this property we have just looked that these products are of just in the same rows and same columns. But in this case, this is not. In this case, just the. So in this case, the sum of these elements with the cofactors of some other rows or columns, just this A11 is in first row and first column, and C21 is just the cofactor of elements of second row and first column. So actually, they are not belonging to same rows or same columns. So in this case, when we find their sum, this will just equal to 0. So these are two important properties. Just we have to remember them, and we have to just use them when during solving the exercises. And so what the third property says, the value of a determinant remains unchanged if its rows and columns are not interchanged. That is, this says that the value of a determinant remains unchanged. That is, when we find the determinant of a given square matrix, that is A, and its transpose is AT, that is the AT is the transpose of A. So the determinant of both this A and this AT will be same. Its determinant will not change. Actually, we will talk about transpose of a matrix. When we find the transpose, then just their rows and columns are interchanged with the real matrix. And so in this case, this happens also. And so A is the square matrix, A is the given matrix, and AT is just transpose. And we all know that how a transpose is made. And so when this transpose is made, then we have to just interchange its rows and columns. And so then finding the determinants are just equal. So the value of a determinant remains unchanged. They don't change either if we interchange their rows and columns. Okay, so this property just says that the determinant of A and its transpose will be same. Now coming on some next point, what it says that, that is, the values of determinant of a square matrix and its transpose are always equal. So this is the property, and you have to just remember this. Okay, now this is another line. This says that if any two rows or columns of a determinant are got interchanged, then the value of determinant changes by minus sign only. This says that if any of the two rows or two columns of a determinant are got interchanged, if they are interchanged, we have to just make their places changed, then this says that their values changes by minus sign only. So look here with example. Actually, this says that A is A11, A12, A21, A22, and B is just A11, A21, A12, A22. So just B is transpose of this. Okay, actually not transpose, we have just interchanged two rows and two columns here. So so just the rows and columns are interchanged. So A11, A21 is the column here, and here it's a row. So we have just interchanged, and so actually B is just edge equals to the transpose of A. So just look here. So this is A and this is B, and so now this says that if we find the determinant of these two matrices, then actually they differs only by a minus sign. They will not equal, but if we apply minus sign here, they are just equal. Okay, so they just differs by minus sign only. So this B will be equals to minus A just. Okay, now coming to other property. So this says that what if any two rows or columns of a determinant are identical or same or a scalar multiple of other, then the value of determinant is zero. This property says that if any two rows or columns of a determinant are identical, that means if they are same, if they are just equal, if they are just equivalent, and if they are just a scalar multiple of other, then the value of the whole determinant will be equals to zero. So actually these are some properties very very important for solving determinant. If each element of a row or a column is multiplied by a constant k, then the value of determinant after multiplication is k times of order 1. Actually this is just similar as the multiplication, the scalar multiplication of matrices. So determinant is also a matrix, it's a square matrix, and so all the what properties of square matrices are applied here. So just this is same that we have discussed about the scalar multiplication in previous videos. So this says that if any element, if each element of a row or a column is multiplied by a constant k, then the value of a determinant after multiplication is k times of order 1. So just we have multiplied k with a, and we have to just find its determinant. So what here, this will become here, this is the determinant of a, and this is the n times of k, and this is just multiplied. So this is written mathematically, and so this statement is forms in this one. Okay, so now we will meet later with a new video and some new topics. So just bye for now.